far would you go for someone you love? Well, Jeff Daniels and Maura Tierney put that very question to the test in a brand new series. American Rust is based on the novel of the same name, and it's a compelling drama seen through the eyes of a complicated and compromised police chief, played by Daniels, when news of a murder rips through town. I caught up with Jeff and Maura on American Rust.
Man can have two reasons for doing the right thing. You'd rather I left you out of this going forward. I get it. No hard feelings.
How does preparing for this dramatic role compare to preparing for a comedy movie?
You approach it the same way. You're playing a human being. You're playing Del Harris, and these are his circumstances, and you get into him, and you let him take you. It's the same thing in comedy. You can't get caught knowing you're funny, winking at the camera and winking at the audience, so the approach is the same. Certainly in Dumb and Dumber, Harry Dunn exists. He's walking around somewhere with an IQ of 8. And he has no idea he's that stupid.
Toss some salt over your right shoulder.
What the hell?
I mean, he came back to do the sequel. And Harry was, you know, middle-aged and still that stupid. No idea. So you make them real and so that they exist and they don't know what they are.
Hey, what do you make of that?
Well, I think that means you're ticked off. Kind of jumpy.
Jeff, American Rust looks like a captivating story from the get-go. What can audiences expect?
They can expect the unexpected. And that's not just a line. It really is the writing. I keep challenging people. After episode 3, tell me what happens next, and you'll be wrong. And the same thing in 5 and 6 and 7 and 8, all the way to the final episode 9. You just don't see it coming.
Our home is being sold today. Why don't you do something useful just once?
Maura, what made you want to be part of telling this story?
I was curious to participate in a project that took place in such a completely different environment than the last television show I had been in.
You're so selfish. How did I not see that all these years?
I mean, I loved the affair and I loved every moment of it. But again, it was a very aspirational show.
Hey, what kind of trouble are you in?
I have to handle this my own way.
This is completely not that. So that was appealing to me, and also the cast, and also the writing.
I'm going to the river where the current rushes by.
It's a serious storyline. Was it always serious on set between takes?
I mean, they didn't have a big gag reel for bloopers. I mean, we screwed up, but it was pretty dark and pretty heavy, and you gotta hit it when the camera rolls.
And it was COVID. Jeff and I literally sat on set in a tent, just the two of us, in between takes from the rest of the crew. So there wasn't a lot of opportunity for, like, goofing off.
Just do your job, and I'll watch out for you.
But what do you most enjoy about working with each other?
She's good. She comes in good. She knows what she's doing. You can talk together about what are we doing. You know, I'd ask her, okay, you know, how do you think about today? What are you looking at? And I'm thinking it's this and that. I don't know about that. Yeah, me too. Let's talk to him about this and that. We were together. It was a team.
This case is poisoning my town.
I think the fact that both of us try to foster a sense of that the other person can feel safe with us helped, because when both people are like, here I am, I'm ready, you could trust me, you could trust me.
Sometimes co-stars can get in there and it's a competition. Who's going to own it? That's self-destructive. And so I've always tried to make the folks around me more comfortable, more open, more trusting, that they can trust that they can give it. And Maura certainly gave it. And eventually, you both jump off the cliff saying, do you trust me? I trust you. Okay, good. Go.
The oath we all took together was we do this for each other.